Hare Krishna. There is no scientific proof that you exist, but scientific proof exists because you exist. In the world today, science is considered to be the foundational and most authoritative form of knowledge. Undoubtedly, science has expanded our knowledge remarkably in various directions. At the same time, we have to recognize that science is a tool that is used by human beings. It is used by consciousness. And science generally looks for natural explanations for natural phenomena. This is based on the methodology of science known as methodological naturalism. So, because science looks for material phenomena, it cannot explore that which is non-material. And the fundamental non-material reality is the scientist or the user of science, the observer who observes and infers and therefore leads to the development of science. So, we as centers of consciousness, we as agents of action are the fundamental reality without which consciousness would not exist. But unfortunately, when some people develop an overconfidence in science, then they end up thinking that science can provide them all answers. And when science cannot locate us as centers of awareness, no telescope, no microscope, no CT scan can record or detect the center of consciousness. So, therefore, some people start saying that there is no such thing as consciousness at all. There is no you, there is no me as a conscious center of awareness. Now, if there were no me, then who is it there that says there is no me? It is a self-contradiction, like somebody saying, I don't know a single word of English. That person has already spoken 8 words of English. So, now the Bhagavad Gita explains that such fragmented knowledge, that knowledge which distances us and alienates us from ourselves, that knowledge which denies the very reality of our existence, is soul destroying. And this knowledge arises from ignorance. The ignorance of materialism, of atheism, of demoniac ignorance. So, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, in 16.9, etam drishtim avashtabhya nashtatmano alpa buddhaya prabhavanti ugra karmanah kshayaya jagato hitah. So, etam drishtim, having accepted this vision, what is that vision that is described in the previous verse? That vision holds that there is nothing beyond matter. Para ekim anyad ataparam, that what else is there apart from the interaction of the matter and the pleasure thereof. So, this understanding leads to nashtatmano. It destroys the soul. It destroys people's understanding of their own spirituality. Alpa buddhayaha, there is intelligence, but this is meager intelligence. And the result of this is prabhavanti ugra karmanaha. Such people end up doing terrible activities. Shayaya jagato hitaha. These are unbeneficial activities that may even destroy the whole world. So, when we deny our own existence, then we end up making our existence meaningless. And this doesn't have to be the consequence of science. If we put first things first, we understand that it is the observer that makes science possible. And thus, we use science as a tool to gain as much knowledge as is possible. But if scientific knowledge is abused to propagate the ideology of scientism that denies the existence of the self itself, then such scientism has to be rejected. And we begin by recognizing that which is the fundamental reality for us. We need to be empirical enough to recognize that our consciousness is the fundamental reality, and which alone makes all other realities possible for us to perceive. So, scientific proof exists because we exist. Thank you. Hare Krishna.